Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is Mihir Prajwal and today I'm going to show you how to use PancakeSwap on iPhone. I'm going to show you how to create a wallet, import an existing wallet, do some swaps, add tokens and much more. So let's get started. Just a quick disclaimer before I get started. None of the things mentioned in this video should be or is financial advice. This is only for educational or entertainment purposes, and always do your own research before investing or using any protocols or services. The process to use a PancakeSwap will be exactly the same on an Android phone as well, but for the purpose of this video, I'm going to use an iPhone. Now, let's jump into the video. As you can see, I have my App Store open, so go to App Store and download MetaMask first. So it's a freely available application that you can download for your phone. And it will be available for free on the Play Store for the Android users as well. It shouldn't take very long. It will probably take a few seconds. As you can see, it has been downloaded. Tap on open. And it says, welcome to MetaMask. You can go through this if you prefer, but tap on get started. So there's two options you have. Import using secret recovery phrase, which I'll go to in the second step. But if you are new to the wallet or if you have never created a wallet, tap on create a new wallet. Click on I agree. Enter the password again. And if you have a Face ID, if your iPhone supports Face ID, you can enable that as well. I'm just going to leave that enabled. Tap on I understand and create password. And it's showing the steps that you can take to secure your wallet. Again, you can watch the video if you prefer. I'm just going to remind me later and tap on start. And this is a really important step. You've got to make sure that you have a backup of the recovery phrase, right? So there's 12 words. You should never give these 12 words to anyone. No one will or no one should ask you for these words. And if someone is asking you to give them these words or connect your wallet to a shady website, that is a scammer and you should run the other way. Now, I do not suggest you save it anywhere that anyone else can access it, because if someone has access to these words, they will have full access to your wallet or any funds that you have in your wallet. So I'll suggest you write it down in a place that's very safe and is only available to you. And now you got to enter the words in the same order that they were in the previous step. And once you have entered everything in a correct fashion, it'll show you that it's a success and click on complete backup and tap on done, and your new wallet is ready. So now I'll show you how to recover a wallet that you already have. For example, if you have a wallet on your MetaMask, on your browser, on your PC, you can sort of sync that as well. So at the moment, the sync option isn't available. It has been disabled for some reason, so I cannot show you that. If you're watching this sometime in the future, the sync option might be there. So if you go to your MetaMask extension, there will be option to sync directly with the phone. But if you have a seed phrase, you'll be able to import that. All right, so just in case you want to import a wallet or import an existing wallet, just a new MetaMask, tap on get started, import using the secret recovery phrase, tap on that, I agree. And you would copy and paste or type your recovery phrase here and give it a password. Just make sure that the password match. And as you can see, there's a green tick, meaning that the password have matched. Click on import. And as you can see, the wallet has been imported. It's going to skip that. No thanks. Right. So this is the wallet. By default, your wallet is connected to the Ethereum mainnet. As you can see on the top, if you tap, you will see Ethereum mainnet, right? So but you need to be connected to the Binance Smart Chain. I have another video that goes into detail on how to connect your wallet to Binance Smart Chain. It will be in the top right corner or in the description as well. So you can watch that if you like a much more step-by-step process. So what I'm going to do to connect this MetaMask to the PancakeSwap is I'm going to go tap on the three lines at the top left corner, and it has a browser built in now. It wasn't the case before. Tap on the browser. This is like your web browser. This is not a special browser for MetaMask. It's just a normal web browser. I'm going to go to pancakeswap.finance. So always be careful, guys, whenever you are browsing or visiting a website with your wallet. You always want to make sure that you are visiting the correct website, or if you are doing a Google search, because by default, it will do a Google search if you don't type a right address. You want to make sure that the spelling is correct, or even rather, you type it yourself, right? Because there's a lot of scams and there's a lot of people that are waiting for you to make a mistake and connect to a shady website or a shady link. PancakeSwap.finance. Click on done, enter, and it will take me to PancakeSwap Finance. As on the top, it says phishing warning. Please make sure you're visiting PancakeSwap.finance, right? So there are a lot of wannabes The websites will look exactly the same like this, and when you tap on connect wallet, and when you connect your wallet, you will give the hackers the full access to your wallet, and they will have access to the funds, they will sell it, they will do a bunch of different stuff. What you want to do is tap on connect wallet and MetaMask, and as you can see, it's asking me connect to the site, click on connect, and it's asking allow the site to add a network. So this is the step where this will connect your MetaMask to the Binance Smart Chain. So by default, it's connected to the Ethereum network, and Binance Smart Chain is a EVM compatible chain, so which stands for Ethereum Virtual Machine. So this is just adding your network or connecting your MetaMask to the PancakeSwap or Binance Smart Chain. Tap on approve and switch network. As you can see, it says new network added. Binance Smart Chain is now available in the network selector. Tap on switch network. Now, as you can see, the wallet has been connected. If you tap on this, it means your wallet has been connected, and as you can see, there's a disconnect option, right? So now how to swap, or how to purchase, how to buy or sell a tokens on PancakeSwap. So now it is going to Binance Smart Chain. So if I go back to my wallet, as you can see, I have $3 in BNB. So how do you fund your wallet? So there's two tokens you can send. You either send BNB or either send BUSD. But one thing that is very crucial and you have to really pay attention is you got to make sure that you send using the Binance Smart Chain or BEP20. So for example, so if you are sending something from Binance, so if you are sending BNB or BUSD from Binance, when you withdraw, you got to make sure that you are selecting Binance Smart Chain or BEP20. So first, what you do is you need the address. So you tap on that. So as you can see, the address has been copied. So you go to your wallet or you go to the exchange, any place that you have BNB or BUSD, and you send the funds to this wallet. But you gotta remember, you gotta be very cautious when you send BNB or BUSD. You are sending it through the Binance Smart Chain network, which is BEP20. If you don't select that while withdrawing your funds will be lost and you will not be able to recover that. It might be very confusing and overwhelming when you are doing this for the first time. For example, all the major exchanges, meaning Binance, KuCoin, Gate.io, all these exchanges will have the option to withdraw as BEP20 or the Binance Smart Chain. So that's the one thing you gotta remember. So once you have sent your funds through to the address that you copied, that's a wallet address, you will see the BNB here. So how to add tokens or import tokens? For example, if you've sent BNB, it will directly show here. But if you sent BUSD, for that matter, what you need to do is you need to import the tokens for your MetaMask wallet to show. If you send any other wallets, for example, if you purchase any other tokens as well, you have to make sure that you import the tokens before you actually see them. So don't panic if you have purchased something and you don't see it here, because you have to manually import that wallet for you to be able to see that. So if you go tap on import tokens, and as you can see, it says token address, token symbol, and token precision. So how do you get the token address? So token address is the contract address of the token that you want to add. For example, for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to add BUSD first. So you'll go to CoinGecko or CoinMarketCap or any other website that has your token address or token information. And I'm going to search for BUSD. And what you want to do is if you scroll, tap on show info. And as you can see, the contract address, if you tap on that, you'll copy it. And then you'll go back to MetaMask and tap on import tokens, token address, paste. As you can see, it's on Ethereum. The logo is Ethereum. If you tap on that, you need the Binance Smart Chain address. So I'll tap on that, I'll copy it. I'll go back to MetaMask, tap on import, paste the address there, and it's detected, tap on import. And if you have some BUSD, it will show here. You see, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add the token Cake, right? So if I go back here, I'll search for Cake, tap on show info. And as you see the logo, right? You'll see the logo here. This is the Binance Smart Chain logo. If you tap on the more information, it is also available on Harmony. So you can see the logo there. It's not available on ETH directly. So you got to also understand if your token is available on the Binance Smart Chain or what chains is it available for. And only then if it's available on PancakeSwap or any other exchange as well. So it has to be, there has to be liquidity and it has to be listed on PancakeSwap before you can actually go and purchase the tokens. You cannot directly buy any token available on any other places. It has to make sure that it is on Binance Smart Chain and it is listed on PancakeSwap. So I'm going to copy that. Since the logo, you got to make sure that the logo is correct. Otherwise, when you paste it, it won't detect it. Go back to MetaMask, tap on import, tap on token address and paste it. I have some cake already in my account, but I can't see that yet. But after I import cake, as you can see, it's showing me that I have 3.2 cake. Right, so now I'm going to show you how you can swap using PancakeSwap. So now let's see how you can sell or buy something using PancakeSwap. For example, so let me sell a little bit of cake, right? So if I go back to the browser and you go to tap on the top and go to pancakeswap.finance and connect your wallet, MetaMask, right? As you can see, it says zero to collect. So that means your wallet is connected. Tap on trade. The currency on the top is what you are swapping the currency at the bottom for. So for example, if you are, so the BNB to cake, meaning you are swapping a little bit of BNB to get the cake, right? But I'm doing exact opposite. So if you tap on the arrow, so it will swap those two tokens. So now I am using a little bit of my cake to get a little bit of BNB, right? That's the first thing. So now let's look at some of the settings that you need to keep in mind. If you tap on the settings icon, the deleted gear icon, there's a default transaction speed. So standard, fast, and instant. The faster you want your transaction to be processed, the more fee you got to pay. But as compared to Ethereum or as compared to our Uniswap, the difference is usually some cents. So I usually use fast or instant as there's no much lag on PancakeSwap as compared to Uniswap. Another thing is slippage tolerance. For example, if I'm selling some cake with 1% slippage, that means I am willing for the price to move 1% while my transaction going through. If it is 1% less, 1% more, I'm still willing for the transaction to go through. So that means if I sell or if I buy whatever asset using the swap feature, I'm allowing the price to move that much, or 1% or whatever percentage that I've put on the slippage, I'm willing to contribute, or I'm willing to sacrifice that much percentage during my transaction. For example, some assets have a slippage of 10% to 12%, because out of your transactions, 3% might be going to marketing, 2% might be going to the reward community wallet and stuff like that. So that's what slippage is. And if you are purchasing an asset that is constantly traded and has a very high volume and the price is very volatile, you want to have a bit of a higher slippage. But if you are purchasing, selling, or buying a regular asset, for example cake for this matter, I can leave the slippage 0.5% because the price isn't moving a lot. It's a bit complicated, but as long as you get the gist of it, it's enough. So I'm going to leave it in fast 0.5%, and depending on how much cake you want to go, you can tap on max as well. But for every transaction, you need to pay in BNB. So that's like your gas fees as you're paying, and it's paid in BNB. And if you are transacting or purchasing an asset, selling an asset for the first time, you need to enable that asset first. For example, in my case, I have never sold any cake. So I have to enable that and approve. As you can see, the transaction completed. Now, once it's enabled, I'll be able to sell my cake and get some BNB. You can also swap your cake for BUSD, or you can swap it to any other asset that is supported. I'm going to swap it for BNB for now. So I'm going to swap all of that. Max at 0.070171 BNB, or if I go to BUSD, it's 37.28 BUSD, right? So I'm going to swap, confirm swap, and the gas fees is 0.00093. And if you like to edit that, you can tap on that BNB. And if you like to, so at the moment you're paying 49 cents, you can, if you go high, you can go low, medium, high. So I'm just going to leave in medium, save, confirm, and the transaction is submitted. Now the transaction has gone through, swapped 3.2 cake for 37.2 BUSD. So I've sold my cake. And there's also an option to add the BUSD MetaMask. So you tap on that, you can add the token directly from here as well. So I've already added that, so that's fine. I'm gonna close it. So now when you purchase anything, you usually purchase it from BNB or BUSD. It's up to you. For example, I wanna buy a little bit of Floki, right? So again, don't follow whatever I'm purchasing. This is not a financial advice. Always do your own research. Go Floki. If I search for it, it is available here. Some tokens are not available here. In that case, you'll have to copy the contract address and paste the contract address here in place of the token. If you search for something, for example, Floki is available here, right? So I don't have to import anything. But if the token is not, or the project is not coming up here, you have to copy the contract address like we copied it from CoinGecko and paste it here. Tap on import. I understand. Import. and Max. And as you can see, I have to enable BUSD as well because I've never used, this is the first time I'm using BUSD from this wallet. Tap on enable, approve. All right, so it's approved. All right, let me try and swap, confirm swap. And you can see it's giving me an error, insufficient output amount. There's a lot of reasons why this happens. One of the main reasons this error happens is because of the slippage. Why? Because the flow key requires at least 3% of slippage, because 3% is deducted and sent to the marketing wallet. So if I tap on settings and increase slippage to 3%, done, close that. And now if I try to swap, confirm swap, still not going through because the prices are probably a bit more volatile. Try 4%, swap, confirm swap. And as you can see, now I can confirm that. So if I tap and confirm, as you can see, the swap has been confirmed. Now I can add Floki to the MetaMask, tap and add, add token, close that, all right? Now, if I go back to my wallet and just refresh it, as you can see, I have received the Floki. That's how you purchase something and add it to your wallet. That's how you use PancakeSwap on iPhone or Android phones. Please let me know if there was any confusion, if you have any questions. I have other MetaMask guides in the description or on the playlist in the top right corner as well. And if you have any suggestions or any other questions, please reach out to me in the comments or on One Life Investment on Twitter. And if you made it to the end of this video, please like the video as that helps out the channel a lot. Subscribe and hit the bell icon for future uploads, and you have a nice day. Thank you.